true story.
Shut up!
Of eight strangers picked to live in paradise.
I listen.
Work together.
Grow up and have their lives taped.
I could care less if you cry.
To find out what happens.
I'm a fucking bitch.
When people stop being polite.
Get over yourself and start getting real.
The real world.
DC.
Is my favorite. Okay, second favorite. I'm joking.
DC's a very, very opinionated political blog in town. We got Hound It and, you know, Stop and things like that, but, you know, we kind of asked for it.
Hound is very much what I'm used to. I went to school in Connecticut, private school.
These are all people.
Yeah. I applied to Georgetown as well, so it's just like kind of the same people, which is a slight pop collar pretension there.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I forgive them for that. Like, they all wear the same stuff, but I think it's adorable.
Hit it off really well, and he ended up being a casting director, so it was kind of funny. I went in there, he asked me to come audition, and I did, and it was just more of a conversation, and I don't know, I just made a bunch of friends along the way, and here I am. I have no idea why.
I was actually studying in a campus computer lab, and I was just so frustrated with school and bored, so I literally just Googled The Real World. Never even think about doing it, but the one time I searched, there's a tryout. So I drove 3 hours to the open casting call, just kind of on a whim.
The tweets here and there, it just probably makes the experience better. It'll bring more people to the bar, and that's pretty much what you want anyway.
Cast, we just had to work a little bit harder to just, you know, try to live our lives normally and not try not to pay attention to it.
Sure. Yeah, it was a little awkward at first. I've never had somebody care so much about what I say or what I do. Mm-hmm. But I think we all, I mean, personally, I got used to it pretty quickly.
I just live my life like I would back in Chicago. You know, I did the same things that I would do back at home and try to pursue all the things that I was currently pursuing in Chicago. So
I don't act it, you know, it's like this is a whole new process. And it's interesting, but the camera guys are kind of cute, so I didn't mind it very much.
Everyone treats us really professionally, but it's on a need-to-know basis, and that's pretty much it.
Yeah, we don't. We would like to get to know.
Yeah. We don't know the names or anything like that.
Day, but we can't.
They do a really good job at kind of staying behind the scenes, and it's kind of like an invisible wall. Like, you're living your life, and they're just observing it. There's no real interaction, so they do a really good job of staying out of the way and helping you forget that they're there.
For me, it's almost better, right? If I was friends with all the cameramen, then they would feel bad if they, you know, capture me doing something I didn't want to.
I'm so much more comfortable behind a camera than in front, so this whole process, it's kind of weird. After the first 5 minutes, you just get used to it, at least for me, I did.
The more the merrier when we go out, you know what I mean?
Yeah, you walk into the bar and like, one or two people are interested in what you have to say, and then a light comes on and they are like,
and then 30?
Flies to the, you know, flies to the pot.
There's a big difference.
And, you know, you can tell.
And it's just like, hey, what's up? You know, it's pretty cool sometimes.
I don't hit on boys. That's not my job.
She really doesn't. She'll
I really
just
don't.
Sit back.
I'll sit back. But, like, if it's obvious that a guy's, if a guy doesn't talk to me when the camera's not on me and a guy talks to me only when it is, do you know what I mean? Like, intention is obvious with most people. You can tell who's real and who's fake.
Yeah.
Intention is a very easy thing to pick up on.
Mm-hmm. We're genuine people, and we're just living life.
We call her Princess.
I don't take offense, though.
You know, it's like meeting anyone else that's new. You know, maybe they have some predispositions about you, but I just go ahead and throw 100% of who I am on it.
I mean, we're not stupid, and if...
Yeah, if we come across as stupid, then we're not coming across as us. Not to keep anything up, so it doesn't bother me whatsoever. Got to be performance anxiety. I mean, maybe not for you.
Oh, for me, it was fine.
We run the party right over the way.
Yeah.
We don't really know exactly what we got ourselves into, but we did it, and everything they're going to show was us.
Something we've done at one point or another. So.
And although it's going to be kind of fun to watch myself.
Yeah. I'm actually kind of excited to see how,
see how they put me together. And
wait and see.
Wait and see.
There's plenty of juicy stuff.
Party every day, party.
It's gonna be a good night. That's a nice